So I'm going to discuss today about application of derivative second topics, that is increasing and decreasing function. One of the most difficult topics for the students to understand is this thing. So I'll be teaching you today the shortcuts, correct? And where the shortcuts will apply and in which question it does not apply. So I'm going to teach about what increasing and decreasing functions today. Fine. For that, I will write a simple question. So if you're unable to hear my voice in this, let me know, okay? Yeah. So first question is find the intervals, okay, for the function f of x. F of x is the function. This is my x. F of x is equal to, one second, I'm just getting a call. So f of x, this is my x, I'm going to write it again. F of x is equal to x square minus 4x plus 6. So today I'm going to teach you what increasing or decreasing function. So first one is strictly increasing. Second one is strictly decreasing. So I have to say how to do it, correct? I'll teach you how to do this. Step number one, first I'll write what solution here. Very important topics, guys, just 1 minute I need from all of you, okay? 1 minute, kindly concentrate. Just 1 minute. So f of x is what? X square minus 4x plus 6. So step one is to find f dash of x. F dash of x is what? Differentiation of f of x. That is, x square difference is what? 2x minus 4. That's it. Correct? Step number two. F dash of x is equal to 0. Substitute f dash of x is equal to what? 0. This implies 2x minus 4 is equal to 0. So x is equal to what? 2 I will get. Correct? Up to this, everyone is clear? Up to step number two, is everyone clear? Everyone. I differentiated, I equated to 0, then I found the value of x. Now, I'm going to tell you a shortcut method. 1 more minute I need from each and every one of you for shortcut method, okay? Because this won't be explained in school clearly. That is the reason I'm telling you. Draw a number line. Schools will explain, but not clearly. Again, I'm telling you. Okay. So x is equal to 2. Mark here 2. Mark this point as minus infinity. Mark this point as plus infinity. Okay. Now for you guys, I'm going to draw a small table also. I'll draw a small table. So guys, minus infinity, right? So I'm just writing what here? Minus plus 2. I'm putting what? Plus. So minus plus, what is it? Minus into plus is minus. So if it is minus, minus infinity to plus 2 is what? Strictly decreasing. Is strictly decreasing. Next thing is what? Plus 2 plus, plus infinity, plus. Plus plus is what? Plus. So 2 to infinity is strictly increasing. Strictly increasing. So did you understand the shortcut here? I'm just drawing a table and that's it. Is everyone clear how to find increasing and decreasing function? Minus into plus, I'm just multiplying here. Plus into plus. Is everyone clear up to this? Fine. So guys, first what I did, I differentiated this thing, correct? 2x minus 4. Then what I did, I equated to 0. Then I just put a number line and I put 2 here. Before 2, up to minus infinity it can go. After 2, what? Up to plus infinity. Then for you guys, I just wrote a table because the question here is to find the intervals which is strictly increasing and strictly decreasing. So for minus infinity, I put the minus here. I'll draw this thing for you guys. Minus infinity, I put the minus here. For plus 2, I put the plus here. Correct? Now again for the plus 2, I put the plus here. This plus infinity, I put here the plus. Correct? So minus into plus is what? Minus. I'll use a spotlight. Minus into plus is minus. Plus into plus is plus. So if it's minus is coming, it is strictly decreasing. If my, I'll write down here, then only you understand. If minus is coming, it is strictly decreasing. If plus is coming, it is strictly increasing. So what was the interval I took here? Minus infinity to plus 2. What is the interval I took here? Plus 2 to infinity. Now is it clear for everyone? Nothing is there in this. Everyone should reply to me. Okay, then only I can tell you one more thing. Guys, I just need one more minute of all of you. Because this won't be explained in school. I'm telling you, this won't be explained in school very clear and very important, not only for the board exam, for understanding engineering and everything. I'm just waiting for one more student to send me the confirmation. One more student, I'm only waiting for his confirmation to do. Give your full attention here now. Okay, fine. Perfect, I got it. So guys, yeah, perfect. So what I told you in the beginning, I'll be telling you the shortcut, where to apply this shortcut. In which question this shortcut does not apply. Correct? So this shortcuts only apply up to quadratic equation. So which means up to power 2, like x square plus 2x plus 3. It will apply there, or to x plus 3. If the function is equal to f of x is equal to x plus 3, it will apply. It doesn't apply to cubic polynomials. For example, if it is f of x is equal to x cube minus 3x square plus 4x plus something, then this minus plus won't work. Is it clear to everyone? This is what in schools they don't teach. They just teach you, okay, step one, differentiate it, done. Equate to 0, fine. Find intervals, you will get it. Okay, but where this shortcut does not apply? In cubic polynomials. If it is x cube or something, it will apply only till what polynomial? This shortcut will be applied only till? I'll write down here, this shortcut will be only applicable to, very important guys, this is the learning today for you. This won't be told in school. You just check with your teacher. When she's teaching, you don't say anything. Just check with them. They won't be telling this. Only with quadratic equation, till quadratic equation, that is x square. After that, they won't mention these things. Is it clear to everyone? Because in textbooks it is not there. These things are not there. This thing is only by experience I'm writing. Okay, now I will explain the long method also. So what I was telling is, see, this question is f of x is equal to what? X square. X square is a quadratic equation, right? These shortcuts only will work with till quadratic equation. It does not work in cubic equation. This is not there in textbook or anything. The words which I am saying now is not there anywhere. Now, what is the long method for this? Correct? What is the long method for this? So this is okay, fine, minus infinity to plus 2. The long method is you have to take one negative value, minus 1. Okay, suppose, so guys, one more minute, you have to be very careful here. If I teach you this thing, my duty is over. Okay, if I'm taking minus 1, then I'd substitute this minus 1 where? I'd substitute this minus 1 in this f of x. So minus 1 the whole square, that is 1 itself. 1 plus 4 plus 6. What is the value I'm getting? 11. Correct? Then you take one more thing called 1. If you put here 1, what is the equation you're getting? 1 minus 4 plus 6. What is the answer of this? 3. 7 minus 4, it is 3. So for minus 1, what is the answer we are getting? Minus 1, I'm getting 11. And for plus 1, I'm getting what? 3. This is one more way of checking whether minus infinity to plus 2 is increasing or decreasing. Is this method clear to everyone? Just take 2 points. Is this thing clear to everyone? So guys, what is the takeaway from this question? I'll write on next page. Takeaways. So guys, what do you guys learn? You guys should tell me what you learned in this question. Only applicable for quadratic equation, correct? But yeah, obviously there will be some exception to that, okay, correct? But you want to just apply it only up to what? If f dash of x, okay, just I'll write down the important points here. Please write down these things, takeaways for this. Applicable only for quadratic equations. That is f dash of x. Even for f dash of x, I'm not talking about f of x, it is applicable for f dash of x. Not applicable. Not applicable for negative cubic polynomial. Negative cubic polynomial. Guys, these kind of words won't be there available anywhere. These are my words. That's the reason I'm telling you. So which means in some cubic polynomial it can work. In some positive cubic polynomial it can work. Correct? Negative cubic polynomial doesn't work. But again, we can say in some positive cubic polynomial it can work. But I also told you the normal method also. What was the normal method I told you? Just put some values. Correct? Here -1 and here +1. Between the points, if you put values, you'll get it. Has everyone written down this thing? So guys, remember one thing, to negative cubic polynomials, okay, this particular thing, negative cubic polynomials, if f of x is coming something like minus x cube plus x square, do not use my number line shortcut method. Do not use this method. Only use substitution. Is it clear to everyone? Fine. I hope everyone has written down this thing. Yeah. We will do one more problem, then you will get it now. Okay. Two more problems, you'll do it and we'll get to know this thing. F of x is equal to 4x cube minus 6x square minus 72x plus 30. This is my 3-0 in the last. So I have to find what? Strictly increasing, strictly decreasing. Find the intervals of strictly increasing and decreasing. Find intervals of strictly increasing and strictly decreasing. So I'm just going to write the solution here. Step number one. Step one, differentiate f of x. So guys, I'm writing it out in the very basic thing so that everyone should understand. So f dash of x is equal to what? 2lx square minus 2lx minus 72. Basic differentiation only I'm doing. Okay, with this, what I'm doing, I can take 12 common. X square minus x minus 6. Correct? So this is a quadratic equation again I'm getting. Correct? So 12 into what? If I want, I can prime factorize this thing. What is prime factorization? X minus 3 into x plus 2. This is a quadratic equation I'm getting. Perfect. It is not a cubic thing. It is not, this is not a negative cubic polynomial. This is the learning for you. Okay. This is not a negative cubic polynomial. This is a positive. Correct? Plus 4x cube. Please write down, guys, these things. Okay. Yeah. Then only we'll be very thorough in this. What is my step two? If this is over, what is my step two? I have to. Step two is what? F dash of x is equal to 0, which means 12 into x minus 3 into x plus 2. So since 12 cannot be equal to 0, what should be equal to 0? So x value should be 3 and minus 2. Up to this, is everyone clear? Simple differentiation I did, that's all. Then I equated to 0. Differentiation of a constant is 0. Yeah, perfect. So I got this values. Correct? Then what I can do? I can draw a number line. Minus infinity plus infinity. What are the values I got? 3 and minus 2. So minus 2 should be here and plus 3. Now what I'll do? I'll draw a table. So I just draw one more extra thing if it is required. Interval, correct? Sign. Signs. Nature of the function. Nature of the function. Signs of f dash of x. Okay, first I'll write an interval. What is my interval? Minus infinity to minus 2. Correct. So what is it actually? Minus and minus. Correct. Minus and minus. So that is equal to what? Plus. Minus into minus is plus. That is greater than 0. So what is the nature of the function? This is my function. Okay. F is strictly increasing. Strictly increasing. Next thing is what? Minus 2 to 3. So minus and plus. Minus plus is what? Minus. So less than 0. So F is strictly decreasing. Next one is 3 to infinity. Both are plus. Plus plus. I'll get what? Greater than 0. F is strictly increasing. Is it clear for everyone? Is this clear for everyone? Anyone having doubt now should ask me now. So if you want me to copy down this thing, yeah. Guys, the important thing is this is not a negative cubic polynomial. Okay, this is the important thing. Very important and very easy. You can score full mark. This is a 2 mark in PU board, 3 mark in CBSE. Completed. So can I go to the next page for everyone? Or how is it? They're completed, everyone. If anyone want me to go to the previous page, let me know. Okay, yeah. So with one more problem, you'll be clear. If you have done this, please message me as done. I'll go to the next question. Okay. Done. Perfect. One more done, I'll go to the next page. Yeah. Oh, everyone is done. Perfect. Third question. Find the intervals in which f of x is equal to sine 3x. Correct? X belongs to 0 to pi by 2. Is strictly increasing and decreasing. Strictly decreasing. So solution. So this is a very interesting problem in trigonometric function. This is the learning from for you. Okay. We cannot use a shortcut. We cannot use the number line shortcut. Guys, I am writing down this. Because guys, today I just had a word with one of my friend also, who is working as assistant professor in a college. Okay. So he was also using Zoom and Google Meet for teaching, but they are all using a board actually. Okay. Writing down on the board and then teaching by using the camera. Fine. Or by using a PPT. Clear? So I asked him, okay, why can't you teach it on the board? It is much more convenient, which on the Zoom whiteboard. Okay, fine. But the thing what he said to me is there should be a lot of effort we should put in writing. Correct. And second thing is PPT is very easy for me to do it. Okay. So one thing is writing on the board, everything write down and just explain the thing. Second thing is making PPT. Once I have PPT is very easy for me. And just cut, copy, paste the entire thing. And I should just use this spotlight and tell you guys, this is the thing, this is the thing, this. That's all. Fine. So I'm writing down each and everything because then only it will go to your head. Correct? Because if it is PPT, me, if I am a student, I won't listen that much. But if some teacher is writing on the board, definitely I'll listen. Okay. So please consider this one last question for this topic. Then I'll take a new topic. Please do that. Let's complete this thing. So in trigonometric function, we cannot use the number line shortcut. So we have to use what? But step one is same. What is my step one? Find f dash of x. What is sine 3x differentiation? 3 cos 3x. That is cos 3x into 3. Correct. I got this thing. Now, second step. Step two is f dash of x is equal to 0. F dash of x is equal to 0. So this implies 3 cos 3x is equal to 0. Correct? Or I can say, I'll write down here. Yeah. Cos 3x is equal to 0. So, what value of cos is equal to 0? Cos 90, right? Cos pi by 2. What is the value of cos 90? Cos 90 is what? 0. Or cos pi by 2 is equal to what? 0. So instead of 0, I'm putting cos 90. Is it clear for everyone? Correct. So what is my 3x? This cos and cos will get cancelled here. So what is my 3x value? This is equal to pi by 2. What is my x value? Pi by 6. Correct. And it is clearly told in the question. It is what? 0 to pi by 6. I'm just bringing it down. 0 to pi by 6. I'll just bring it down. So which means if I use my number line method in this, what is my number line method? What I do? I write down zero, correct? It should be zero. And it should be what? Pi by 6, and it should be what? Pi by 2. If I use number line method, between 0 to pi by 6 is what? Plus plus positive, correct? Yes or no? Pi by 6 to pi by 2 is what? Again, plus plus positive. But guys, we cannot use a shortcut in trigonometric functions. So what I should do? I'm just writing it down one more time here. F of x. What is f of x value? Sine 3x. Correct? So I am putting in 0 to pi by 6. First interval. So if I put 0, what is my value of sine? 0 itself. Sine 0 is 0. What is sine pi by 6 value, guys? What is sine pi by 6 value? What is the value of sine 30? Sine 30 is 1 by 2. Very good. 0 to 1 by 2. So one value is 0, other value is 0.5. So is it increasing or decreasing? One value sine 0 is 0. Sine pi by 6 value is what? 0.5. 0 to 0.5. Is it increasing or decreasing? It is increasing. Very good. So at 0 to pi by 6, I am writing it down here. 0 to pi by 6, it is strictly increasing. Strictly increasing. Strictly increasing. Pi by 6 to pi by 2. Now next one is what? Pi by 6. I'll write it down here. Pi by 6 to pi by 2. Pi by 6 value is what? What is my pi by 6 value? So guys, one small thing I have to do here. Okay, I made a small mistake in the question. It's increasing only. But guys, 0 to pi by 6, no one told me this thing. 0 to pi by 6, see. One second. Yeah, this one no one has told me. See, if I'm putting 0, it is sine 0, 0. But if I'm putting pi by 6 here, what should come? Sine 3 into what is x value? Pi by 6, right? Correct? So it should be 0 to sine pi by 2 value is what? 1. So it should be 0 to 1. Yeah. So guys, even if I make any small mistake, please let me know. Anyway, the answer is same only. Answer is same. 0 to pi by 6, answer is same. Strictly increasing. But make sure that we substitute here in this question f of x value. Now coming to the next thing. Pi by 6 to pi by 2. So what is my pi by 6 value? Pi by 6 value I got it as 1. Now pi by 2 value I'll write down here. So sine 3 pi by 2. So 3 into pi by 2. Correct. What is my value of sine 3 pi by 2? So 3 into 180 by 2. What is it? Sine 3 by 2. Only one answer I got. Sine 3 pi by 2 value. I want everyone to try it. Whatever answer you get, let me know. What is sine 3 by 2 and answer? Only one answer I got till now, two answers I got. Sine, yes. Sine 3 pi by 2 value is what? What is 3 pi by 2, guys? I am here. Okay, guys, don't get confused here. I am in here. What is sine 3 pi by 2 meaning? Sine 270. That is equal to what? Minus 1. Why it is minus 1? Because 270 is in third quadrant. So sine is negative in third quadrant. Correct? So it is 180 plus 90 sine pi plus theta minus sine theta. That's it. So this is minus 1. So if I'm shifting from 1 to minus 1, is it strictly increasing or strictly decreasing? 1 to minus 1. 1 to minus 1, is it increasing or decreasing? Is it strictly decreasing or strictly increasing? Two answers I got till now. Both are correct. Others, 1 to minus 1, da? Everyone, very good, Riya. So 1 to minus 1 is what? Strictly decreasing, correct? So from pi by 6 to pi by 2, it is strictly decreasing. 0 to pi by 6, it is strictly increasing. Is it clear for everyone? So guys, the mistake which I did, that also you should note down. Even though I got the correct answer, I got strictly increasing. I was happy with that. Correct? But we have to substitute here in place of x. Is it clear for everyone? Yeah. So learn from my mistake also. Even though I got the answer correct, I should teach you everything very accurately. That is the biggest challenge I have. So whatever I am teaching you, that should be 100% accurate. So if everyone has copied down this thing, I'll go to the next one. So everyone has done. Is there any doubts in this strictly increasing and strictly decreasing? Any doubts for anyone? Very important topic, 2 mark or 3 mark question. So I clearly told you what to do. Fine. If anyone wants me to go to the previous page, let me know that also. Because I'm going to take a new topic. If you have doubts, you should ask me now itself. Any doubts is there, ask me now itself. No doubts or any doubt? No doubts. Perfect. Yeah, fine. Tangents and normals. Okay, so first thing is I'll draw the diagram for you, then I think it'll be easy for you to judge this. So guys, a kind of curve I have drawn, right? Correct? A kind of curve I have drawn. Correct? Now I'm going to mark a point A. Correct? the one which is perpendicular this particular line. This is called the normal of A, this line. The one which is passing through this, this is called what? Tangent of A. So I know everyone knows what is a tangent. The question here is what? Tangents and normal. What is tangent mainly? Tan theta, correct? Or dy by dx, or slope, or m. What is this dy by dx? This is also what? Our f dash of x, correct? Differentiation of f of x. Is it clear for everyone up to this? Tan theta, f dash of x, everything is same. Up to this, is it clear for everyone? Then I'm going to write an important thing. The slope, that is what? Our dy by dx, correct? The slope of the normal to the curve. The function I'm giving y is equal to f of x, okay? Is nothing but what? Minus 1 by f dash of x. That's it. Suppose if f of x, the point is what? X naught comma y naught. The curve point is x naught comma y naught, just like our coordinates. I should write here f dash of x naught. That's all. Up to this, any doubts? This is a formula. This is a formula. That's all. Next thing is, we all have studied this formula. X minus x1 by x2 minus x1 is equal to y minus y1 by y2 minus y1. How many of you have not seen this formula? At least not seen this formula. Yes, everyone knows this, right? Yes. Somewhere you might have seen this. Yes. So I hope everyone has written down up to this. Then I'd go to the next page. Equation of normal to the curve. Y is equal to f of x at x naught comma y naught. Is given by, very important this is, y minus y naught is equal to minus 1 by f of x naught, that is slope, correct? Into x minus x naught. This is my x, very important. This formula is very important. Not only this, previous page, even this is important. Please copy down this thing. If everyone has done, just let me know. I'll do the next question, okay? Done. Very good. Question number one for this. Find the slope of the tangent to the curve, y is equal to x cube minus x at x is equal to 2. Write in solution first. Tangent means what? Tan theta or dy by dx. That's it. Correct? So just differentiate this thing. Dy by dx is equal to what? 3x square minus 1. Correct? At x is equal to 2 means what? I just put x is equal to 2 here. So 3 into 4. 2 square is 4 minus 1. What is the answer of this? 11. That's it. That's your answer. The slope is what? Dy by dx, that is equal to 11. Step 1, differentiate, substitute the value, you get the answer. Simple as that. Is it clear to everyone or any doubt? Clear. I hope you should have completed it, or else I'll send you later this thing. Next question. Find the point at which, please write down with me simultaneously, tangent to the curve y is equal to root of 4x minus 3 and slope. So here, points means what you define. Slope they are giving us 2 by 3. So I'll do the solution. Already they're given as what? Slope. That is dy by dx they're given. 2 by 3 value. Slope value they're given. And I define the points. Points is what? X naught comma y naught or x comma y, whatever it is. Okay, it is either x naught comma y naught or x comma y. It doesn't matter. Now what I'm teaching you is how to do this question. Y is equal to root of 4x minus 3. First thing is, y is equal to root x differentiation. So what is root x differentiation? 1 by 2 root x. And what is x differentiation? 1. That's how you get 1 by 2 root x. Correct? Same principle I'm applying here also. Y is equal to root of 4x minus 3. What is dy by dx? Root x is 1 by 2 root x. So this is 1 by root 2 root of 4x minus 3. What is 4x minus 3 differentiation? 4x differentiation is what? 4. 3 differentiation is constant. So multiply by 4. That's all. Is it clear to everyone? Then I am cancelling this 2. 2 times this thing. Correct? But it is not over. Dy by dx value they already given. What is the value given? 2 by 3. Correct? The given values are 2 by 3 they have given the value. So I can cut this 2 and this 2. So root of 4x minus 3 or 4x minus 3 is equal to what? 9. Because I'm taking squaring on both the ends. If you don't know, I'll write here 4x minus 3 is equal to 3. So squaring 4x minus 3 is equal to 9. So 4x is equal to 12. X is equal to what? 3. X is equal to 3. So x value I got here as 3. If I got x value as 3. Okay, if I got x value as 3, I'd just put here 3. So 4 into 3 is what? 12. 12 minus 3. So root 3 is, root 9 is 3. Root of 9 is 3. So y value is 3. Correct. Y value is what? Y value is again 3. That's all. Is it clear for everyone or any doubt up to this? No, x value is not 3 by 2, x value is 3 itself. X value is 3, y value is 3. So what is the points? Points is 3 comma 3, that's all. Please write down this. Once you're done, let me know.